The Privatization and Management Office is selling 143 government assets. The Department of Finance expects to generate 2.54 billion pesos from this to fund the state's priority projects. Among the properties in the list are assets in Metro Manila, such as the Elordes Sports and Tourism Development Corporation and Emmanuel Community Hospital in Tondo, Manila. Properties of the abolished Technology Research Center in different regions are also up for grabs. Colliers International Associate Research Director Joey Bondoc believes some of the assets are in prime locations that are due for redevelopment. He says it's a win-win situation for the government and interested property firms.
Those have very high traffic properties. For the government, of course, it enables them to raise non-tax revenues, but also for the developers, they will now have access to these very good properties that they can redevelop into what? Integrated communities, master plan communities, office buildings, malls, and even hotels.
Bondoc says even though interest rates are high, making it more expensive to buy real estate using loans, the government shouldn't have a problem selling. Architect June Palafox says the asset sales could have been more profitable for government if the Constitution didn't ban foreigners from buying and owning property here.
The Philippines is 400 times the size of Singapore, 350 times the size of Hong Kong, 8 times the size of Taiwan, 3 times the size of South Korea. And many countries in the world, including Dubai, they allow foreign ownership of land or leasehold for a long time. In fact, in Dublin, Ireland, the Guinness Brewery, the leasehold is more than 1,000 years. And in fact, the leasehold to foreigners, we should keep it longer if we cannot sell to foreigners.
Bayan Muna Chairman Nery Colmenares isn't happy with the assets up for sale, particularly the sale of Emmanuel Community Hospital in Tondo, Manila, and the government's 3.46% stake in NLEX Corporation.
Hindi ba maganda nga? In fact, dapat gobyerno tapatakbo ng NLEX. Eh. Kasi kung i-privatize mo yung NLEX, mga private companies yan, siyempre yung una nilang intention dyan, bakit sila nag-invest dyan, eh tubo. Kaya hindi ko maintindihan ng gobyerno na nagbebenta ng shares sa NLEX na napakahalaga sana na foothold ba, meron ka doon at least say sa loob ng korporasyon na yan para madepensahan mo naman ang tao kung sakaling mag-impose sila ng mga unjust toll rate increases.
DA Market Securities Chief Equity Strategist Nisha Alicer meanwhile noted that the government might have a hard time selling its shares in NLEX Corporation, with the tollway business being heavily regulated.
A lot of investors are not as keen on regulated industries. It attracts a lot of attention when there's a lot of regulation, and it sometimes can confuse the conversation.
DOF data show the sale of government assets in the first 6 months of Marcos administration totaled 800 million pesos, exceeding the total privatization proceeds of 664 million pesos from 2019 to 2021. Lady Vicentio, ABS-CBN News.